Captain Marvel had two post-credit scenes, one that set up Avengers Endgame with Captain Marvel arriving at the Avengers facility just after the Thanos snap, and the other as Goose the Cat coughed up the Tesseract, or better known as the Space Stone. But there was actually a third post-credit scene that was deleted from Captain Marvel. But luckily enough, we have the details on what entailed this post-credit scene and who exactly was involved, including a planet that we've actually seen before. The post-credit scene was supposed to follow Yon-Rogg, which is Jude Law's character. If you guys remember to the end of Captain Marvel, Carol Danvers sent Yon-Rogg back into space, presumably Hala, to bring a message to the rest of the Kree. That message that Carol Danvers, or Captain Marvel, was going to end the Kree-Skrull War, but mainly to destroy the Supreme Intelligence, who was still around at this point in time and a major threat. This post-credit scene that was ultimately deleted would follow Yon-Rogg as he arrived on a planet, but it would not be the Kree homeworld of Hala. Instead, Yon-Rogg would crash land on Sakaar. One of the directors of Captain Marvel had this to say about the deleted concept for an end credit scene. There was an idea on the table about having Jude Law emerge from his pod on Sakaar, and then having him look around and see the Devil's Anus behind him and wonder, where the hell am I? Again, this really wouldn't have led into anything major, as we don't see Yon-Rogg in Thor Ragnarok. Presumably, Yon-Rogg will in fact be appearing in Captain Marvel 2, although we're not sure yet. There are thoughts and rumors of having the Captain Marvel sequel take place before the Avengers yet again, and it would make sense for Yon-Rogg to return since he's not dead yet. But of course, this post-credit scene was meant to be a very comedic one, indicating that Yon-Rogg did not make his way back to Hala, but instead went where all junk goes and landed on Sakaar. Although this would have been a cool tie-in to Thor Ragnarok, I understand why they ultimately decided not to go with this, as we're not really sure at this point in time what they want to do with the Yon-Rogg character and how they want to bring him back. Perhaps one of the reasons they didn't go with this post-credit scene is they have plans for Yon-Rogg to return later down the line, and that they wanted him to deliver the message to the Kree Empire and the Supreme Intelligence. I guess we'll have to wait and see though, as I'm almost positive Yon-Rogg will pop up yet again down the line in the MCU. But ultimately guys, what are your thoughts on this post-credit scene and Yon-Rogg landing on Sakaar, the world that we saw primarily in Thor Ragnarok? Do you guys think this was a cool idea, or would you have liked to see something different? Again guys, don't forget about the Thanos Hot Toys giveaway. I'll briefly go over the rules now. To enter to win a Hot Toys Thanos figure, all you have to do is like the video, subscribe, turn on notifications, and tell me below who your favorite MCU villain is. Once you've completed this, you've officially entered to win a Hot Toys Thanos figure. Anyway guys, thank you so much for watching, subscribe to join our team, and have a great day.